y'all go, man. Tall Guy Car Views back with another video, baby. What are we talking about today? Hold on. First and foremost, tallguycarviews.com. Get your merch ASAP, man. But I am headed out of the house, man. About to go run some errands. I got big legendary news coming y'all way, man. Big snow out today, man. Y'all see it in the background? Without further ado, let's get to the video. You see the title. You see the thumbnail. I'm getting a new exhaust put on my Dodge Challenger Hellcat on my Hellkeezy, baby. This is about to be super duper legendary, man. And y'all ain't gonna believe what I got. But I do know that y'all will approve of the exhaust I got put on, or I'm getting put on my Hellcat, man. So everybody stay tuned, man. I'm telling y'all. And what y'all think, man? Y'all think I should go with some headers, or should I just go full exhaust? Let me know if you think that I should, if you think I should buy some headers or not for my Hellkeezy, man. Because already today, I purchased the full exhaust for the Hellkeezy, man. And when I tell y'all, it's top of the mook, it's top of the mook, baby. And I paid some racks. Everybody stay tuned, because I'm telling y'all, when y'all see it, y'all gonna go crazy, man. I'm telling y'all, y'all gonna love it. I even personally think I'm gonna love it. And this is something y'all know I don't even do. If I wasn't doing YouTube, I guarantee you 1,000%, I would have never modded my Hellkeezy. I would have never got this track on. And shout out to G-Squad, man. I appreciate it. I love y'all so much, man, because y'all made me the tall guy car views I am. I say it now, and I'll say it forever, and I said it before, man. No matter how big I get on this YouTube, man, I would never stop showing love to y'all. I would never stop appreciating y'all, man. Because like I told y'all, y'all made me the tall guy carvers I am, man. So this is 100% for y'all, man. So stay tuned, and y'all gonna enjoy this, man, big time. But I gotta head to the store real quick, grab a new modem for the crib, man. I gotta upgrade that Wi-Fi to get this, you know, these legendary videos put up. Hey, y'all wanna know something that's funny? There's a Jeep SRT right here next to me. Let me show y'all. How legendary is that, man? Jeep SRT right next to the Jeep Trackhawk, the Hellhawk. In the Jeep SRT, big legendary. All right, man, I'm back. Had to go in there and grab a new modem, man. And then, it's a long story what happened with the internet, man, but I had top of the mook modem, and then next you know, they came out with an even more top of the mook internet, so then next you know, I'm not receiving my whole top of the mook internet through my so-called top of the mook modem, so I had to go back to the store, grab the most top of the mook modem to match my top of the mook internet. But now, got everything taken care of, got a few more errands I gotta run, man, but for the most part, I got the main things done today, did what I had to do so I can do what I wanna do, but now I got my internet, that's about to be pumping and jumping the way it's supposed to be, so I can get y'all these videos every single day, because y'all know me, I'm a workaholic, the grind don't never stop. And shout out to the people up in the store too. I know big G-Squad members out there, man. Shout out to y'all. I appreciate every last one of y'all, man. But without further ado, let's go ahead and start the Hellhawk up. Big legendary, man. Big legendary. But speaking of the G-Squad members out here in the store right here, man, that I appreciate so much, just like y'all tuning in at home and all that good stuff, man. I actually was at the gym this morning. If you follow me on Snapchat, you'll see that. Corey Barrett, one word, follow me on there. But I was in the gym this morning, man, and I had a real G-Squad member come up to me, and I'd never seen him before in the gym, and he came up to me, couldn't believe it was me. He went crazy. It was dope, man. We were sitting there chopping up for a good little minute, and he said to me today, and I really wanted to talk to y'all about this today, man, because it was mind-blowing to me. He told me today, he was like, you know, man, you motivate me, you inspire me, all this other stuff, and how much I just motivate him to get on his feet every single day and get off his ass and bust his ass to get what he want, do what he has to do so he can do what he want to do. He was running my own quotes and everything I say right by me. You know, it was the funniest thing ever, but it was so dope and surreal at the same time. We were sitting there chopping up for about a good 30, 40 minutes after I got done hooping, and he was like, man, you got the perfect life and everything and all this other stuff. And I had to stop him. I had to let him know, just like I'm about to let y'all know right now, is I know for a lot of people are just watching me, cool. Then you got some people who are watching me, hate me, cool, so what, I appreciate you. But then you got some people who I really do inspire and motivate. Those are to the real G-Squad members, to the real core fan base of mine, G-Squad, those who I inspire and I motivate and all that good stuff. There's a lot of y'all that look at me and they think like, man, he got the Hellcat, he got the Trackhawk, he got this, he got that, you know, I got my old girl, I got my shorty E. You know, there's a lot of people that look at the perception of my life and they automatically assume that I'm just like, I'm worry-free in my life. Then that's, you couldn't be more wrong if you thought that. And I was telling him that this morning, like, it's crazy how the perception can go so far with some people. Like, you look at celebrities, movie stars, rappers, actors, whatever, and people automatically assume that these people just got it all together, that they got the answers, that they all the time 99.9% all the time happy. No, people, I am a human being. Like, I got bills to pay. There's times where I'm in a slouch, you know, there's times where I gotta pick myself up off the ground. I gotta tell myself to keep on pushing. I am human just like y'all, man. I don't have everything. Like, y'all just looking at the perception of me. Like I said, this goes for the G-Squad members who are really like that, you know. For the ones, okay, disregard, skip passes, whatever. But for the real G-Squad members who really look at my life and be like, man, that's goals. It's not, it is But it's not. You know, like, I'm not solidified in this game. I'm not solidified in life. Like, I'm still on that climb up right now, you know? There might be some things in y'all life that y'all got that I don't have. And there's things in my life that I have that y'all don't have. So for the people out there who's aspiring to get a Hellcat, who's aspiring to get a Trackhawk, you know, y'all looking at my life, man, like, man, that's, man, he doing this. And I am. I'm big time blessed. But y'all doing y'all thing, too. There's things out there that y'all are doing that Slim, Tall Guy Carviews has not done yet, that Corey Barrett has not succeeded in yet, that I have not done yet. Like, it was funny running into this dude today, man. I'm not going to throw out his name because I don't want to blast him or, you know, put him on blast. But he was talking to me like I was just 100% rich. Like, oh, man, what you going to do next? You going to get the Lambo? You going? And I'm like, bro, I'm not rich, bro. You know what I mean? Like, not at all, not even close. But I'm out here doing what I have to do so I can do what I want to do. If when you're rich, you're doing what you want to do every single day. I'm not doing what I want to do every single day. When you're rich, you do what you want to do every single day, 365 a year. I'm not doing that right now. Like, I'm on a budget every single month. So I'm setting myself up in the best way I can, or the best way I think will set me up in a position to be able to get wealthy, to be able to let my kids' kids be rich and all that other good stuff. I want to put myself in a position where I can take care of all my family. I don't have to just take care of one or two. Or, yeah, you know, I want to be able to take care of all my loved ones that I really love and really have my back. I want to be able to do that. I'm not in that position yet. But it was funny because as he was talking to me, he was saying that, like, I was just already solidified. The perception of me and what's going on in my real life is two totally different things. Now, don't get me wrong. Have I been blessed? Am I in a position where I can take a trip to Hawaii, go scuba diving, Shark Tank shit, and it's not hurting my pockets? Buy a Jeep Trackhawk, not hurting my pockets? Yes, absolutely. I'm big time blessed, but I'd be lying to sit here and say I'm rich or I'm wealthy and I got it all figured out and I got all the answers. No, and that's the last thing I want y'all to ever think. So I'm still on the climb just like y'all, but I might be in some ways up a few more steps, and in some ways y'all might be up a few more steps than I am, you know. But I don't ever want y'all to think that I'm just rich and I'm just doing this and I don't know. I'm out here doing what I have to do every single day, busting my ass, grinding every single day for y'all to see the highlights of my life. But it's not nothing like I'm just, this is regular every day. I just get up, wake up, and take a flight to Hawaii. No, I got to structure it up. I got to go on a budget. I have to do these things. So if y'all want to do these things, I'm letting y'all know it's not me saying, oh, look at me, I'm shining out here on y'all. This is me saying you can do it too if you do these X amount of steps correctly. Now, is mine the best blueprint ever in life? Absolutely not. There's a million ways to get to one destination, and you got to know that. This is just one way that I'm taking. But for the people out there who don't want to do it my way, you can do it your way and make it how you want, but you have to structure it up. You have to be smart. You have to do what you have to do every single day to be able to get to the point where you can do what you want to do. Y'all know how I get down, G-Squad. Like right now, I'm about to get my little guy something to eat. I'm out running errands. Who the hell likes running errands? I mean, let's be honest. Who likes paying bills? Who likes running errands? But yet, I'm out here doing it like I'm enjoying it. Like, but because I know this is what it takes for me to get to where I want to go. Long story short, don't just look at my life and say, oh man, he's got it. He's got the master plan. He got a niche or whatever. Look at me and say, I can do it too. If anybody could take away one thing from my whole entire YouTube channel and every last video that I've made, which is over 400 of them, and I've only been on YouTube for a year, so you got to know and understand 420, 430, 440 videos, whatever amount of videos I got, there's only 365 days in a year, and I got over 400 easily videos. So it lets you know how much I'm busting my ass every single day. And anybody who does YouTube or makes videos or does edits or does thumbnails, y'all know how time consuming it is, how tedious it is, and you can't just finagle in YouTube. You got to really be dishing out the content. You really got to be real on this motherfucker, man. So for those people out there who's looking at my life, I want you to take away a million things if you can. Soak it all up. Whatever you feel like you can learn from me or take from me to make you propel to success or be able to get to the point you want to be in life, cool, take it from me. That's what I did to get to where I'm at today. But for the people out there, if you only gonna take one thing away from my whole entire YouTube channel, take this away. Whatever I'm doing, whatever you're watching me in this video do, and all my other videos that you've seen me done in the past and that you're gonna see me do in the future, you can do it too. I no lie to you, man. I've said this before in so many of my other videos, man. And to my guy who I've seen in the gym earlier today, this for you too, champ. Always believe that you can do it too. There's nobody in this world who's doing something that you can't do too. They got blood pumping through their body just like you got blood pumping through your body. They breathe in this air just like you breathe in this air. Ain't nobody got no superpowers. Ain't nobody Superman. That shit is all fictional. That's all sci-fi shit, man. This is real life. And for the people who's only gonna take away one thing, and one thing only on my YouTube channel, take away the fact that you can do anything that you put your mind to. You can do anything that I'm doing. There's no difference between you and I. at all. Like, I used to watch people on YouTube, man, and I used to just be a consumer of it. And I'm like, you know what? Why don't I just make my own YouTube videos? I'm on YouTube so much, I still watch everybody on YouTube. Low key, I'm not gonna lie to you, I watch everybody still. I'm still subscribed to people, still be watching people. I'm not lying to y'all, man. This is really what I do every single day, and I love it. But I just one day was like, why don't I make the YouTube channel? What's different from this person, or that person than me? Nothing. And once I made that up in my head and I told myself I was gonna do it, boom. All the results came later, and look where we at now. Even though I'm at where I'm at right now, there's, to me, I'm not big time, but there's a lot of people who look at me in the perception of what I'm doing, and they're like, oh, he big time, he famous, he this, he that. I don't look at myself that way. Every single day, I'm always sitting there contemplating, thinking, and trying to make my next move my best move, always trying to be better today than I was yesterday, always trying to be better this year than I was last year, and the year prior to that, man. This is a never, non-stop ending grind, man. It's hard, man. And you got to bust your ass every single day and appreciate every single moment. The good, the bad, the hella fucking ugly. I know I went on a long rant right here, man, but I just wanted to tell y'all that, man, because it was just crazy to me how this person, shout out to you again, champ, thought that I just had it, like, all together. Like, you know, like I don't go through a struggle period now. Like, don't get me wrong. It's a little bit different for me now, momentarily. Ain't no telling how I could be a week from now, how I could be a year from now, how I could be 2 years from now. YouTube can end, and then what? But then the same thing is, you put it all on the line when you have the opportunity to do so. You can always tell the people who's going to be successful in life. You want me to tell you how? Because people who aren't going to be successful in life, they look at things differently than a person who will be. And what I mean by that is, let's say, like how I just said, YouTube could end tomorrow, and I could not just be kaput. Right, and I got all these cars, I got all this other stuff happening, and it just end. But the thing is, the difference between me and the person who won't be successful, and God willing, I will be successful, is the fact that they look at what ifs a lot. Like, if this happens, or if this happens, or if this happens, when you constantly thinking about if this happened, or what if this happened, or I got fired, or I got laid off, or this, or this, or that, that's gonna determine how hard and how much you bust your ass every single day. Whereas a person like me and the people who want to be successful in life, they understand without risk, there is no reward. And if you got, in order to get a big reward, you got to take a big ass risk. It don't just come by taking a little minuscule risk and then you just get a super dummy, tsunami substantial reward. It's just not how life works. You got to take big ass risks to get big ass reward. So people know that if was a fifth, we'd all be drunk, man. So to the people out there who feel like, man, I don't want to do this because if this happens, or if this happens, man, I'm gonna be done. Man, listen here, man. If you're thinking like that the rest of your life, congratulations, champ, you'll never be successful. But for the people who don't feel that way, who are like, you know what? Well, I got this opportunity. I'm gonna bust my ass. I'm gonna do what I have to do every single day, and I'm gonna take these leaps of faith. I'm gonna take all the risk I have to. Calculated risk now. There's a difference between risk and calculated risk. Calculated risk is something that's gonna help you in the process of trying to get your business to take off. And that's what I'm doing. That's what y'all should be doing. And anybody who say they really want to be successful, that's what they had to do in order to get to where they at. But for the people who are not willing to do that, you will never be successful, because there will never be a perfect time to take a leap or to take a risk. There's never going to be a perfect time. But I just wanted to let y'all know this, man, because it's so crazy to me how people, when I go somewhere and people run up to me and they say these things, it's like I really got to sit back and I have to talk with them and say, what about my life makes you feel like it's just that perfect? It's the videos. Because think about it. When somebody plays a basketball game, right? At the end of the game, they don't show all the bricks. They show the highlights, man. So us YouTubers that are dishing out this content and giving all these videos, excuse me, those are highlights, man. That's not really reality. Like, it's just the highlights. Don't get me wrong, reality can be highlights, you know, sometimes. But the thing is, you kind of skip out all the bad parts and give y'all all the good shit. Because if I put up a video today and just said, oh man, shit, man, my phone bill due, man, rent due, man, oh man, my car payment 1 month behind, man. Who the fuck wanna hear that shit? Nobody wanna hear that shit. So you giving them your highlights. And as YouTubers, like I'm gonna keep telling y'all and always gonna tell y'all, as YouTubers, we have to lead by example. I don't know if all YouTubers are doing this, but I know I do. I don't say nothing to y'all that I don't do myself. I don't tell y'all to take a bunch of calculated risks and so you can get to the reward. I do it myself too. I don't just say it. I live by this shit. I don't say go top of the MOOC and I'm not top of the MOOC. I live by this shit, man. This shit is real. There's no games being played. I'm not putting them over side. Now, other YouTubers, I can't speak for them. But I'm telling you, this is how it should be. As YouTubers, you should stand by what you're telling your people. And G-Squad, y'all know that I live by this. I stand by this. I don't hold back nothing. This is real and this is really my life, man. I just want to tell y'all real quick, for all the people out there who look at my videos and watch my videos and I inspire and I motivate you and all that good shit, look at my life and know that behind the scenes, there I'm still going through things too as well. So I'm about to go in here and get Ethan something to eat, man. But last thing I want to tell y'all, man, before I head up out of this car is I want to let y'all know, like I told y'all a million times over, no risk, no reward. And also, there's no time like the present, man. So get your ass up every single day, put your best foot forward, try to be better than you were yesterday, try to be better than you were last year, and that's how progression happens, that's how success happens, man. Always remember and always know that whatever you've seen on TV, on YouTube, and all that other shit, it's all highlights, man. Don't get me wrong, they might be blessed, like I am big time blessed, don't get me wrong. I remember last year, I was pissed, poor, broke, or a year and a half ago, 2 years ago, it seemed fucked up. But now I'm in here sitting talking to you in a Hellhawk with red and tears, got a Hellcat, got Honda, got a motorcycle, got my girl, got a Jeep, I'm taking care of my family. Like it's a big time blessing, don't get me wrong. But at the same time, I have not made it to the point in life where I'm rich or I'm wealthy or nothing like that. I'm still on a budget, just like y'all. I might just have a few more scraps than some. But then for the people who are out there, y'all doing better than the people who just piss, poor, broke and homeless. So there's just different levels to everything, man. But what's happening in my life, I'm not perfect, and I just wanted to let y'all know that because he kind of just sparked the thought in my head this morning, man. But like I said, follow me on Snapchat, and you'll be in the loop, and you'll see everything, man. But without further ado, I'm about to go ahead and get something to eat, and I'll see y'all when I get back. All right, man, we back in the whip. Got the food for Eve. Headed to the house right now. Got to take care of a few more things along the way, man. But for the most part, man, I got everything I wanted to tell y'all today in this video out of the way, and I told y'all, man. Got the exhaust coming. Stay tuned for the exhaust. Still, comment below. Let me know if y'all think I should get headers, or if I do get headers, which one y'all think I should get. Also, got a few other things taken care of, you know. Got to tell y'all what I want to tell y'all today, man, and I hope that inspired and motivated a lot of people, man, to get up off their ass, do what they gotta do every single day, man, so that way eventually they can get to the point where they can do what they want to do, man, because I'm doing the same thing every single day. And trust me, even though I'm living, this is a dream job, don't get me wrong, I'm living a ferocious life, I'm big time blessed, definitely in comparison to where I came from, man. So without a doubt, don't ever think that it can't be done or whatever, because I'm a living testament that y'all know I tell y'all this every single day, all the time, man. Maybe not every single day, but I tell y'all this all the time, man. Y'all get what I'm saying? It's a dream job. I can't complain about my life, and nor in any kind of way was I complaining about my life. I just wanted to let y'all know, man, the perception of anybody's life can be a motherfucker in versus reality. And the reality is, every single day, I'm busting my ass, making videos, doing what I have to do every single day to do what I want to do. Count how many times I done said that shit, man. And I hope that you count it up, add it up, and you incorporate that shit into your life, man. But this is not a game. Even though this is YouTube and it's a dream job and everything I'm doing is a big time blessing, it's still work nonetheless. Even though I love it so much, that don't feel like work. But then there's some things that do feel like work. Paying bills, doing all this stuff. This shit is tedious, man. Editing videos, making thumbnails, that's the shit that I could do without that. You know what I mean? And I'm doing it all myself. I ain't got nobody doing that shit for me. So I'm out here doing it myself every single day off the strength, man. So you got to understand and know that there's a process to every single thing that you do in life in order to become successful. There's a process. You can't just skip from one end to the other unless you, like I said in all the other videos, you got to be dummy rich or your parents rich or something like that. But speaking to my real G Squad members and the people who come from my background and been through all that shit, you know that it's just no skipping the process, that you got to appreciate all the good shit with the bad shit, man. And that's what I'm doing every single day. I'm out here giving you these videos. I love this shit, but at the same time, it's every single day and the grind don't stop, man. There's other shit I gotta do too, so you gotta think about it. Ain't enough time in a day to do all the shit that I want to do every single day, man. So y'all know that too, and then incorporate that into your life as well, man. But without further ado, man, this video is over, it's done, nothing really else to talk about, man. I'll see y'all in the next video, man. Talk about car reviews. I'm out of here, man.